Therefore, XA equals to mole fraction of solute. XA equals to mole fraction of solvent. XA equals to mole fraction of solvent. XB equals to mole fraction of solute. Then mole fraction of solvent equals to XA equals to, that is mole fraction of solvent equals to number of moles of A by total number of moles, that means NA plus NB. This is the mole fraction of which one? Solute. It is what? Mole fraction of solute. Mole fraction of solute. Mole fraction of which one? Solvent. Then coming to the XB equals to number of moles of solute by total number of moles NA plus NB. This is the moles of which one? Sorry, mole fraction of solute B. Mole fraction of solute B. Okay. For very dilute solutions compared to NA, NB is very less. For very dilute solutions or dilute solutions compared to NA, NB is very less. Which is very less? Compared to NA, NB is very less. So therefore, NA is greater than which one? NB. So NB is neglected for dilute solutions. Which is neglected? NB is neglected for dilute solutions. For very dilute solutions, solvent is very more compared to which one? NB. So therefore, mole fraction equals to, that is mole fraction of XB equals to NB by which one? NA. mole fraction of XB equals to NB by which one? NA. If B is solvent, B is solvent, A is solute, for dilute solutions, NB is greater than when compared to which one? NA. In this case, mole fraction of A equals to number of moles of A by number of moles of which one? B. NA by NB. Above case is what? NB by NA. This is the principle which is useful for okay now. So therefore XA plus mole fraction of solvent plus mole fraction of solute always equals to which one? 1. If you want mole fraction of XB equals to 1 minus XA. One minus which one? XA or one minus XB.